interesting question, and it reminded me of the importance of that issue in the whole emergence of the study of religion, not theology, but of religion. The early anthropologists who said that religion got its start because people were worried about where the dead went, or they saw them in their dreams and they had to account for these ghosts. That the dead as a category had to be explained. And so early anthropologists of religion took thinking about death as being a starting point for humankind. And of course, theology takes it a slightly different way, a interaction with our own mortality being the way death might promote religiosity. And so I would have to grant that death, in terms of the death of our loved ones, death as a way in which to understand the human condition, and if the human condition is a mortal one, what does that mean about consciousness in the world? And perhaps even our fears of wandering souls. Indeed, I think that must be very important to religion. One of the things about Buddhism that makes it qualify as a religion is the lovely story in the scriptures of the woman who comes up to the Buddha carrying her dead child and says, "Oh, you have to do something for my child. He's dead and I'm just so broken, and you have to do something because he can't be dead. He can't be." And the Buddha looks at this poor woman and says, "I'll help you. Leave your child here and go to every household in which no one has died and bring back one grain of rice." One grain of rice from every household in which, and the woman must have thought that there was a formula here, and if she could get the rice, she hurries off, really pleased to have this project. And she comes in at the end of the day and said, "There is no household in which no one has died." And the Buddha gave her back her baby, and she could accept the child and understand that death happens, it's the nature of life, there is no life. That sense that it can't happen is wrong. It can. And that is, confrontation is one that is a very human one we all have. And that very much puts Buddhism dealing with the issues that have been fundamental to all religions, whether there's a God or not. But at the same time, I think we might be religious if we had no death and didn't have to worry about death. Something that's almost impossible to imagine. It's a real thought experiment. As I mentioned earlier, a little bit beguiled with the other things that I see as sort of real commonalities in religion. And I'm taking the most homely ones that you can imagine. And that's the desire for healing. And maybe if we didn't die, maybe we had no physical impairments or problems with disease. And so if we didn't have that, what would we have left? I think we might have the desire to improve our station and ask for wealth. And we might have the desire to identify forces that we could interact with. And so rituals of some sort, maybe not the great ones to account for mortality and transformation into another form, but maybe the homely ones of tending shrines and maximizing our good luck by tending the shrines. That might be some form of religion that would emerge, but I'm not sure. It's a good thought experiment.